Well, during stressful experiences, emotions can feel more challenging than usual. Today, we're talking with Carrie Whatley, who is a licensed professional counselor who helps people cope with stress and anxiety, a lot of what many of you are feeling right now. Carrie, thanks so much for being with us. What should people keep in mind when dealing with strong emotions?
Something to keep in mind is that every single word we use has an emotional charge to it. So when you're feeling strong emotions, we really only feel them after we've labeled a situation with words. So say you're stuck in traffic, one person might say, you know, this is just awful, I'm furious, this is horrible. And the same person, a different person in the car behind them experiencing the same situation might go, this is inconvenient, or this is a little annoying. And so even though they're in the same situation, the fact that they labeled it differently, they experience it differently.
All right, so that's something I think we all can resonate with. What are some tips to use words that might help change our outlook instead of just jumping to that negative word right away?
Well, you want to use the lightest version of the word that you would usually use that you can. So instead of saying 2020 has been the worst, you might say 2020 has been challenging, right? Or instead of saying, you know, this is awful or terrible, you might say this is disappointing. So you just want to use the lightest version of the word that you can, and that lowers the emotional charge that goes along with the experience.
And perhaps this is good advice for a lot of parents whose children are going back to school, and we know things are going to be different when the kids go back, maybe to choose our words very carefully when talking with our children.
Absolutely, absolutely. The kids always take their cue from us, and so if you're calm, they're going to reflect that back to you. If you're upset, they're going to reflect that as well.
Right. Well, Carrie Whatley, thanks so much for being with us. Some great advice today on choosing our words carefully. We appreciate it.
Thank you.